Hi traders, here's a new video. First of all, the risk warning: your invested capital might be at risk. Don't trade with money you cannot afford to lose. And this video is not investment advice. So this video is another binary options trading, price action trading, binary options strategy part two video, where I'm gonna talk about those kind of trades which I have already done. But I want to show you those kind of concepts which I apply on those kind of trading regarding to the ebook. Yes, because we have weekend. I'm a European trader and I do not have the OTC market available on the weekend, so I cannot do live trading examples. Yes, and so I will do this kind of recap of those kind of trades. Important here, because I got so often this request from traders who wants to know which kind of concepts from which page I apply on those kind of tradings. Yes, when I do any kind of trades. And I can only recommend to anybody to get this ebook. Yes, you find the link in the description. This ebook contains the most important candlestick pattern, chart pattern, binary option, turbo trading concepts, market condition, trend identification, rejection, and candlestick mass, and a lot of more concepts which can be applied to any kind of time frame, any kind of financial instrument, and any kind of broker. Get this ebook. You'll find the link in the description, and in the description we'll find also the link to the Facebook group. So okay, here let's start immediately. Don't waste any time. Here is the video. We have here a shooting star. Yes, and here you see immediately what kind of concepts you can apply. Shooting star. Yes, let me show you this here. Shooting star. I entered here already in the put, because I have done here before the introduction to the ebook, and I don't want to show you that again. As here we have I have to do this a little bit faster, so I will do this only that I show you the trade, and then I will show you what kind of things I apply here. So we have a shooting star. Yes, that concept will apply here. Yes, a pullback, because we got here an engulfing candle, downtrend, price came back. Here we got a shooting star, so that is a pullback of the 20 EMA. Then we have here the shooting star itself. Let me see, shooting. Yes. Shooting star itself, yes. And that is this one here, this bearish shooting star. Yes, here you see most favorable. It's a reversal pattern. Yes, so we can expect that price will go down further. And then we have the trend channel, the market condition. Yes, let me show you this, the trend channel. That are those videos about the trend channel. It was maybe this one here. Yes, here, downtrend, trend channel. Yes, you can see this price is here in this kind of trend channel. Yes, then we have here applied this kind of behavior about support and resistance, because those trades are based on support and resistance. Then we have here also the trend, and most often this one, which I have explained over and over again, the concept about about support and resistance. That is this one here, yes, where I talk about the minor SNR and the major SNR. Then this one here, where I talked about when you should trade those kind of support and resistance level after it was validated. Yes, it became major SNR, then you trade them. And then obviously this kind of videos where I talked about the EMAs. Yes, this one are those one important one. Yes, where I talked about the Bollinger Band, what the Bollinger Band are telling, and what the moving average are telling. Yes, which are really crucial, which I can only recommend to that to pass through them too, because that will happen. And that will be covered in each and every video and each and every way trade. Yes, that are those in this case the basics which you should know inside out. Yes. Okay, so let me see. I entered here into a put. Yes, after the shooting star. And I will do fast forward, because I don't want to show you over and over again those trades. Yes, so we got here the shooting star, and you see it unfolds really nice. We have a major downtrend here. Yes, when we got a shooting star, which is, and we had also a Bollinger squeeze with a small consolidation area. Yes, and now after the shooting star, you can apply this kind of concept here, which I have explained in this kind of video, where I talked about the high spot highest probability trading setups, yes, where you got here engulfing candle, but this can be everything, yes, shooting star, pin bar, or yes, dojis, yes, which are at some kind of pullback doing, yes. This engulfing candle is only an example of those candlesticks. It can be also chart patterns, yes, double top, double bottom, head to shoulders, and so on. After this, you can expect a downtrend, and that is what you can expect also here. After a shooting star, you can expect a downtrend. So, I didn't enter here into the next trade. Yes, I was drawing, I was explaining something, and then this candle finished. Yes, and then I maybe entered. Yes, I entered here into this trade. Why I entered into this trade? I entered into this trade because this is the Bollinger squeeze here. Yes, you see here, Bollinger squeeze. That is the concept. Yes, Bollinger squeeze. And after the Bollinger squeeze, a small consolidation area here. Yes, this was this candle was a consolidation. Yes, and then we got a breakout. Yes, and that after this candle broke through this kind of area. Yes, you could enter into a trade. Yes, because this was a breakout of this channel. This candle is showing selling pressure. This is important because there are also fake breakouts. I will cover this more in detail when I'm doing this kind of trades here and explaining those kind of trades, where then I will show you why you should not enter into a trade, in such a trade, if you have a weak candle or something like this. Yes, because you have to understand that you need pressure to continue to a breakout. Yes, here in this kind of scenario, the volume would be also bigger, yes, but it would already too late, because then you would already in the on the halfway. So then here's the alignment of the EMAs, which are telling that price will go down further. Here we got the crossing of the 20 SMA with the 20 EMA, yes, the middle Bollinger band with the 20 EMA, which is telling that we are getting into a pullback. Here you see that the both lines are getting wider. They are spreading, yes, they are getting out of widen, they are wider, yes, and that is already a sign that the trend will continue. And then obviously the breakout here, the Bollinger breakout, yes, which is showing that we are getting here into such kind of downtrend. So let me continue this with fast forwarding to reduce the time, because you should already have seen this. So after this, we got a fast reversal. Let me do play here so we can see this. Yes, a fast reversal. I'm zooming out, and then price shoots up. Yes, and then I didn't enter into a trade because I was not sure what's happening here. We are going here now into a ranging market. Yes, because the EMAs are not so steep downwards. Yes, it looked at the beginning. Yes, because now we are getting into a reversal, and it is looking like there will be some kind of engulfing candle. Yes, touching the support and resistance level. Yes, which is confirming this one. Yes, the second touch of this level is confirming this. So, and then we got here this engulfing candle, and I'm doing here a put against this engulfing candle, and that is due to the market condition. Yes, because you see, we are getting here this downtrend is getting yes, it's not yes, the downtrend is still active. Yes, you see, if you would draw here this kind of line, let me show you this. I cannot show you this. I have to show this. This is a trend line here, yes. And here we have another one. So you see, we have here still this kind of trend channel, yes. And because of this support and resistance level, which is in confluence with this kind of with this trend line, yes. Of this trend channel, I entered into a put, because and this candle with this wick is showing me that we are getting here selling pressure at this level. This wick already showed this too, and we have a major downtrend. We have now here a minor downtrend at the edges, yes, and that was the reason why I entered into a put, and that also because this is not only a downtrend, this downtrend is not anymore so strong like it was before, yes, and that was also the reason why, I can say that it's strong like before, and that was the reason why I was sure that price would go down from this level, but I would not expect that price would have been gone so down like it's gone, yes, because it's going already much more. But that is another concept which I have explained in the ebook too, where I covered the prediction of the next candle, and you see now what will happen if the distance. Let me show you this, because so I can explain to you why this worked out in this case and not like you should expect. So I have explained how to trade the engulfing candle. If price touches this level, you trade in a call. Yes, this is. But if you get immediately that price will go up, yes, you can expect that price will retrace back below the closing price of the previous bullish engulfing candle. That is that one what I have explained in this kind of videos where I talk about. Let me show you this. Let me show you this where I do have this. Yes, it was here, this one. That is important, because here is a nice example of this what I have explained here in this kind of video. Yes, this one here. Engulfing candle, yes, candlestick, engulfing candle, yes, here you see that is an entry point. That was not this one what I was talking about. That is what I'm talking about, is this one here. You have an engulfing candle. We have here, what do we have here? A bullish, yes, bullish engulfing candle. Let me see, bullish engulfing candle. So price, yes, starts to go up, yes, here, bullish engulfing candle. Then you don't enter into a call, yes, because you want to do a call, yes, you expect to do a call. You don't do this X here, yes, you see this X, it means you don't enter into a call, because price goes up, and after this price will continue to go in down, yes. And on the engulfing candle video, yes, where I have talked about the engulfing candle, let me show you this, because you see how all those concepts are getting together like a gear, yes, it's all working together. It's not only one video, yes, and you have covered all the topics. You have to get them all together, yes, because it's a general. So here on the engulfing candle, so if this space here, we have the bullish candle, so if we have this space here, yes, let me show you this. If we have this space here, the space between this closing price and this opening price of the previous candle, if this space here, this and this one, yes, is too big, yes, and price starts to go up, that what I showed you in the purchase time, then you can expect that in the expiration time, price will go back, and that's the reason why you get that a bearish candle. That is what you often will experience after a bullish or bearish engulfing candle, that you get the opposite color of the candle, yes, because of the movement. That's what I have explained in the ebook about the purchase time and the expiration time. That's what I have tried to explain you in this kind of videos here, yes, and that was the reason why I entered there into a put, because I understood from the movement, yes, from this one here, I understood from this movement here, yes, that price got up before, yes, and then it got down, yes, that price will, and that the price, that the next candle will be most probably a bearish one, and that is the reason why I have done here an X, yes, across, because to show you, don't stay away. But it doesn't mean stay away, it means only that price could get a bearish candle. That is the same concept which I have explained here, why I told you to get at least below here in this kind of area into the crate, yes, because you have to understand that most often price gets back lower this, and so you have the margin of safety in case that the distance between this candle closing price is bigger, much bigger than the opening price of the previous candle. It's a little bit complicated, it sounds a little bit complicated, but if you understand this concept, you will get most often the best possible entry points, and that is what I have done here. I saw the distance here between those two areas here. Let me show you this. Between those two areas is so big, this one here, yes, and this one is big, that is this space here, yes, this space here, and that was the reason why I entered into a put, because this candle moved up first, I entered here at this level, and then what I was expecting, that price would go down, yes, and that is what I have done here. Every other trader who would trade only this candlestick pattern blindly would have entered at this level here into a call and would have been out of the money, only because he didn't understood this kind of concept about the engulfing candle. Yes, that is this one. So let me see what's happening. You see, price is going down, doing some kind of panic, and after this, it closed at a bearish candle, yes, instead of a bullish one. But then we are getting here the next one, yes, that what I have explained, the next concept which I have explained here about the prediction of the next candle after such things happened. And let me show you if I can find this here. It was the concept about yes, about the weak candle. What's happened? Yes, engulfing candle. Let me show you this one. Yes, this one. Yeah. You get an bullish engulfing candle. The next candle will be a bearish one. Yes, the next one will be a bearish. Here, this one. Yes, let me show you this. And what do you expect next? Next candle will be a bullish one. So we have here a bullish engulfing candle. The next candle was a bearish one. And after this, what can you expect? I don't have this done, but you see here, price will go up. Yes, that is the concept which I have explained. And you see, those concepts are working very well if you understand them completely, yes, and in combination with all other things. So that was already. If you like this video, do a like. If you didn't subscribe, subscribe to my channel. And if you have something to say, drop me a line in the comment section. So I would say stay safe and bye bye.